Well, hello there. We are up quite close and personal today because I'm so excited to be filming using the new Mary Kay Fall 2019 products. So, what I'm going to be featuring in today's video is all coming from page 20. Oh my goodness, this Feel Fierce palette is so gorgeous. So this is the look that we're going to be doing, or really it's going to be more so inspired by. And this is the palette. These shades are so beautiful and fun for fall, quite pigmented. So we're gonna jump right in. I feel like I say that every single video, but that's exactly what we're doing. And I'm just gonna prime my eyes. So as you can see, I have nothing on my face except my brows. So using the eye primer, and then I'm gonna go in and this shade right here. Oh, what is this shade? It's one of the Mary Kay cream eye colors, and it's not apricot glaze. This one is pale blush. So I'm using this almost similar to like a corrector just to kind of cancel out. As you can see, I have pigmentation on my eyes. And because I haven't done my makeup, I don't have any concealer or anything. So I'm gonna use that first on my lid. And then I'm just gonna go ahead and jump in with Cinnabar. I use this shade every tutorial because it's literally perfect for any transition, especially when I'm doing like a dark or deep smoky eye like I'm doing today. So I'm just gonna go ahead and add that to both of my creases, and then we'll jump right in. So next, picking up Pomegranate, which is probably one of the brightest and most pigmented matte eyeshadows I've seen from Mary Kay in a very long time. So just taking that on a smaller, denser crease brush, I'm gonna go ahead and just add that to my crease. So starting in with just a little bit of product and then slowly starting to build it up as I go, just because this is kind of like the statement shade of this eye look. But I just want it to blend in very nicely right on top of where we put Cinnabar, and then taking the eyeshadow brush that we use with Cinnabar just to go ahead and blend out those creases. We are taking this eyeshadow very high, so do not be surprised that it's very blown out and smoky. So next, going in with Rose Gold, I'm just gonna add that right on top of where we put that cream eyeshadow color. So as you can see, the cream eyeshadow works as a great base, really just to hold onto that color. So it's kind of like double duty. We did eye primer, cream base, and then eyeshadow. So next, I'm literally just flipping over my brush and picking up Hummingbird, which is similar to what you would see in other makeup brands, kind of like a duochrome shade, where you look at it and you're like, okay, it kind of looks silver, but it kind of looks blue, but it kind of looks green. It literally just changes and shifts as you turn your eye. So I'm just picking that up and putting that on the outer V, almost 2/3 of my eyelid. And I'm just going in and packing that on. So again, to get some more color payoff, I am gonna go ahead and pick up my finishing spray, gonna spritz my brush just a little bit, and then continue to pack on that color. Okay, so now going in with probably the most daunting shade in this palette, and of course, it's a matte black. This shade is the shade Onyx. And so what I'm doing is I'm starting very, very closely to my lash line, and then I'm going to pick it up and smoke it out and add it to that outer V as less product is on the brush. So as you can see there, that looks very sharp, that looks very harsh. Do not worry, we are going to blend it out. So after you've added some product, go ahead, take your blending brush and go ahead and blend back and forth. And I'm literally just gonna do this on both eyes. I'm gonna add some Onyx, I'm gonna blend it out. I'm gonna add some Onyx, I'm gonna blend it out. Now, of course, picking up some more Cinnabar and just blending that out. And just making sure that there are no harsh lines, that everything looks nice and blended. As you can see, this is a very, very blown out smoky eye. So if you don't want to take it as high as I did, you do not have to. If you don't want it to be as smoky as I have it, you don't have to. You can literally make this as dramatic or as subtle as you want. And now I'm literally just going and lining my lash line, no wing, just a simple thick black line just so that our lashes look a little more voluptuous. And then going ahead and picking up some more of that hummingbird and just adding it right in between where we put rose gold and onyx, just because I wanted to make sure that blue could really pop. So then of course, nothing new here, adding some lash primer, and then I'm gonna go ahead and knock off some of the excess powder and eyeshadow follow that happened. And then of course we're gonna jump in using the newer Mary Kay Time Wise foundations. This is in the shade 130 Warm. And I'm just gonna go ahead and add this. This is part of the Luminous set. So I've been using the matte, I love the matte, but I did go ahead and switch to the Luminous one for this one. And then gonna go ahead and continue per normal. Gonna add some concealer. This is in light bronze. Gonna add some contour in deep bronze. Gonna sculpt, gonna highlight, gonna powder, all of that good stuff. And I'm back, because obviously you cannot see what blush I just put on. So I used the blush in Desert Rose. I use this one all the time. It's just so pretty. Gonna go ahead and clean up my contour a little bit with some more translucent powder. And then we are going to jump in and finish off the eyes. So jumping back into that shade, that's not Hummingbird. Which one is this? It's the red shade we used. It escapes me right now. But we're just gonna add that to the lower lash line. Gonna go ahead and blend that all out. And then, of course, gonna jump and make sure that both eyes are even. If you need to use your blending brush to clean it up, go ahead and do that. And then gonna add just a little bit of cinnabar to the bottom of that so it makes it blended, makes it match what we have going on up top. Make sure everything looks nice and seamless. And then we are going to jump into Onyx just a little bit. And I'm gonna add this just to the outer corner of my bottom lash line. So we are almost done with this look. I'm just gonna take a little bit of rose gold and I'm gonna add that in the inner corner of my eye, obviously to add an inner corner highlight, just because this look is so, honestly, it is so smoky. I don't even normally wear something this smoky on a normal day, but just to kind of help to bring it to life, bring it forward, add that inner corner highlight, go ahead and add some mascara to your bottom lashes, make sure you add mascara to the top, then you're gonna jump in with some lip primer, and then three things you're going to need. Go ahead and line your lips. I am using the liner in Deep Nude just because the lipstick shade we're gonna go in with is quite a nude on me. It's like my true natural nude. So I'm just gonna go ahead and line my lips, and then we are gonna go in with medium nude in the inside of the lip. So we're kind of doing an ombre, but really I just wanna make sure that the lipstick doesn't get lost in my skin tone and in my lips. So just go ahead and blend that out and then add the lipstick. This is a limited edition lipstick in Tenacious Taupe, and it's gorgeous, and it's matte, and it's so great for fall. So I hope you guys have enjoyed this video, and I'll see you in my next one.